In this video, we will learn more about HTTP module. Currently, we are in section 3 and we are about to check out the second video of this section. So here I have my file of httpmodule.js present within this folder. You can get the source code link in the description. Also in the terminal, make sure you navigate to this folder. Now all of these code you already saw in our previous section when we created our first Node application. The first statement has the require function that includes the HTTP module. Once we get the object of the HTTP module, we can then use it to create our server that has a request listener, and the request listener function receives HTTP request and response as a parameter. And in the response object, we can then write some code, such as here I am writing hello world, and finally end the connection by using the end function. And down below here, we are using server.listen function that listen to this port. As a second argument, we have the confirmation callback that is executed when the server is created successfully and is running. Now let us take our discussion a step ahead. So within our HTTP response object, suppose you want to add a header along with the status code. So for that, we have a special function of writeHead, which accepts the first parameter as the status code. So I will pass here 200, which means success OK. In short, everything went fine. We are sending back 200 status code as a response. And then you can define your header. So here I will type content type as text HTML. Well, this is the key and this is the value. And the content type header is a predefined header. Well, text slash HTML is the most commonly used one. You can also have application slash JSON if you want to send JSON response to the client. Now apart from this function, we also have another function that only adds header to your HTTP response. For example, response object dot set header. Here I will add the header as location and then provide its value. The value could be any. Here I am just sending back the URL. You can also add one more header of your own choice. In this way, you can add as many header as you want, like this. Fine. Now within this function of writeHead, suppose you want to add one more header. So in that case, you can just put a comma here and define your own one more header in the form of key value pair, like this. Now proceeding, suppose you want to read a query string coming in your HTTP request object. So in that case, what code you need to write? So for that, within this request object, there exists a property known as URL. So in that case, what you can do is down below, just add one more function, response object, use the write function, then use request object dot URL. So this URL is actually the property of this request object, which will extract the part of the URL that comes after the domain name. Save the file and let me show you what I'm talking about. Run this code. So here our server is up and running. So let us hit that URL, localhost slash 9000, hit enter, we get nothing, blank. Now right after the URL, if you type something here such as January, hit enter, so in the end you will get January here. Now suppose if you hit here as pizza, then you will get pizza here accordingly. How cool is that? Let us explore how to split the query string. That is, how to extract the query parameter if we have that coming from the client in the form of URL. So in that case, what you can do is, you can just use the URL module. Well, URL is another module which we will explore shortly in this section. But right now, let us get a sneak peek of that, what this module do. So here, let us use the URL module dot use the parse function and then use the request object coming from the client and use dot URL. Now this URL is basically the property of this request object, and this URL is actually the URL module that we have defined here. So please do not get confused about it. And as a second parameter, pass true. Finally, call dot query. So this query will actually get all the query parameters or the query data from this URL. And then using this query data, you can extract the details. Suppose in our URL, we are getting the name. So I will use name And also suppose we have the second key value pair of age. So in that case, we can use query data dot age. Plus you can create a statement. And then on the left, you can define another variable, the message that you want to send back to the client. And instead of this, let us use the message. Save the file, shut down the server and rerun it. And now in our browser, I will just pass the query parameter. And the syntax to pass the query parameter is use the question mark after the domain name, then define your name. And this name is actually the key, which should be same as the name that we have defined here, along with define the value. And now for the second query parameter, you need to use the ampersand and define another key, which in our case is the age, which we want to extract. So I will use age equal to 25. So after question mark, you define the first key value pair and then a ampersand followed by the second key value pair like this. If you hit enter, then you are going to get Shreyank is 25 years old. How cool is that? So now you wonder while browsing any website, why you get the URL in the form of this. They are basically the query parameters. And in the server, we can extract the query parameter like this with the help of key here. Fine, we can get the value. So this was a very short video on HTTP module. Well, a lot more can be discussed here, but since this is a beginner course, so let us keep the thing simple. In the next video, we will learn about file system module. See you there.